Welcome to ECE 3300 at the University of Utah. In lecture number 23, we're going to talk about displacement current. Displacement current was originally observed by James Clerk Maxwell. He noted that there are two sources of the magnetic field. We're familiar with one, so if we were calculating the magnetic field using Ampere's law, we would have used a current, and in this case it's a conduction current, and that would have produced a magnetic field. But there's another term that produces a magnetic field, and that's a time-varying electric field or electric flux density. If we take this and we integrate it over the surface, we're going to come up with another kind of current, and that's called a displacement current. So this is one form of Ampere's law that includes Maxwell's displacement current term. The other form is the point form, which says that the curl of the magnetic field is equal to the conduction current density plus the displacement current density. So we could use either of these forms of Maxwell's equations. This is the new form of Ampere's law. So let's consider the classic case of the parallel plate capacitor. In a parallel plate capacitor that's connected onto some voltage source, the current, which is a conduction current, passes into the capacitor and then out of the capacitor. And in here, let's suppose this is air-filled, there must be some other form of current in order for the current IC to come in and then to come out. And this is the displacement current term right here. The displacement current term is going to be the integral of the displacement current density over the surface, and that is going to be the integral over the surface of the electric flux density that's passing through that surface. So if I had been given the electric flux, it would be very easy to calculate the conduction current from this equation, but most often we're not given the electric flux. Most often what we're given is something like the area of the plate and the dielectric material that's in that plate and the voltage that's driving the plate. Now there's an important equation that says the electric field is equal to the voltage divided by the distance between the two plates, and it's in this direction. Let's suppose that that is the z direction. So the electric field is the voltage divided by the distance, d, between the two plates, and then we know that d is equal to epsilon times e, so that is epsilon naught times epsilon r times the voltage divided by the distance. Well, if our voltage happens to be, let's say it's cosinusoidally varying, so v is equal, so the voltage is v times the cosine of omega t, now we know our electric flux density, and we can find our conduction current term. So our conduction current is going to be the integral over the surface of the time derivative of epsilon naught times epsilon r times v over d cosine of omega t. That is z-directed, and we need to use the z-directed surface. Let's suppose that this plate is a square plate. The z-directed surface would then be dx dy. Well, these two terms dot to 1, and all of this can come outside my integral, so I get epsilon naught times epsilon r times v over d. What about the time derivative cosine of omega t? That can come outside also. When I take the time derivative, I get omega, and then I get minus the sine of omega t. And then, when I do this integral, surface integral right here, I'm going to get the area of the plates. Now, would it have mattered if my plates had been round instead of square? The answer is no, because this surface integral would still have given me the total area of the plate. Now, let's take a look and see if that is consistent with the capacitive current that we would expect. If we had a capacitor, we know that the current that's passing that through that capacitor would be C dV dt. And the capacitance here is going to be omega minus and then the sine omega t, just like I've got up here. So let's see what my capacitance is. Oh, and I need to include my V term there. Capacitance is epsilon A over D. There's epsilon A over D. I, in fact, was able to calculate the current through the capacitor.